What we have here is that will be the Tropic of Cancer. And this will be the Tropic of Capricorn. And so, of course, Australia is out here. We actually had the solstice yesterday, Eilish, the 21st of December. So the sun is now at this point here. Our friend the sun is right here now at this extremity. And this is the Tropic of Cancer. And here we have
the equator.
This video is for a long-time viewer in Melbourne, Australia. So we'll just say 8 o'clock here, 8 p.m. That's when the sun goes down in Sydney, Australia, on December the 22nd at the solstice or roundabouts. And this would be the rise time here, just say 5:40. So that's 9 hours and 40 minutes. So just proceeding through, 9 hours and 40 minutes comes to roughly 9.6. It's actually 666 repeated, but so just out of 24 hours, we don't have to be 100% accurate, but we'll just get a nice number there. So we've got 40%. So basically here in Sydney, Australia, we would have the sun visible in the sky for around 60% of the time. 40% of the time, it wouldn't be visible. So this is Sydney on the concept flat earth map, and around here you have the pathway of the sun at around December the 22nd. And as we have worked out, we can see the sun in Sydney for around 60% of the day. So what I'll do now is I'll just move this pie graph over here. Just to get a bit of an idea. So this bluish part here would represent 40%, and this yellowish part would represent 60%. So the line of sight would be about that length right there. I'll just place this one across here. Now, of course, we would be able to see if this is the length, if we take an arc. We could take an arc through here. I'll take the pie graph away. I'll now place an arc there so that we can get a bit of an idea of where we can see from Sydney. And we'll put it right there. I'll blot the other parts out a bit. So according to Santos Bonacci in Sydney, we can see the sun for this far here, for this length. Now, this means that during the winter months for the southern hemisphere, for Sydney there, we would be able to see the sun all of the time, right in the dead of winter here, around June the 22nd. So 24 hours a day, we should be able to see the sun, because we can see the sun from this length here. And of course, it arcs around here. That's the area that we should be able to see the sun, because we can see the sun from here to here. Of course, this has nothing to do with the reality of living on this planet. What I'll do now is take a line that is the same length, and I'll show that it's the same length. Yeah, pretty much, you know, the same length there as our lines. That's how far we can see across the flat earth. And I'll place it on, this is New York right here, so I'll place it on New York, and we're going to look kind of across the North Pole. We'd probably have to look through Mount Meru. And if I put it there, you know, like, as you can see from New York, because you've got the same amount of sight, or if I went to New York, I would still be able to see as far. So from New York, you should be able to see the sun all year round, 24 hours a day. You would never have any time where you can't see the sun in the sky. apart from if there's a bit of cloud cover or something like that. And then we have London also. So we'll put that on London. And yeah, as you can see, so that would be the furthest away there, roundabouts that the sun would ever get from London. And you can see that the distance there is a distance, so you should be able to see the sun. Because we can see the sun, as I've described here, along this length here. So this is what Santos Bonacci is basically telling people. And it's a sad thing. And just to add further, he's using the scare tactic that the church uses, and it no doubt has worked on Santos, the scare tactic of demons and demon worship and scaring people into the flat earth thing.